First off, Team Chaos, I want to say thank you for all the support on the ranking series. You guys are blowing those videos up. We have a lot of cool ones to come, but if you have suggestions for future ranking videos, doesn't just have to be Call of Duty, let me know in the comments. Now, the AUG. It's perhaps the gun that changed the most in COD history. I have a soft spot for it. It's been an LMG, it's been an assault rifle, it's been an SMG, it's been a full auto, it's been a burst. You guys get the idea. But which AUG was the best? Today on the ranking series, we're going to be ranking every single AUG in COD history from the worst all the way to the best. Of course, you let me know which AUG is your favorite. Drop a like. Guys, make sure you have those notifications turned on. We're over 20% of the channel having notifications. Let's turn them on, ring that bell, and let's kick things off with Modern Warzone. Dead last, my friends. The Modern Warfare AUG as it appears in Warzone. Now, this version of the AUG is a full auto SMG. And it does have some use, it's just kind of weird in multiplayer. The Modern Warzone AUG, it has a pretty slow fire rate compared to the other SMGs. It's loaded with drawbacks, and you have to fix all those in the gunsmith. Small magazine, moderate damage, ugly iron sights, and the handling speeds, well, they're nothing to write home about. The Modern Warzone AUG is best used with the ammo conversion at mid-range. This is not a run-and-gun SMG like many others are. So how does this gun fare at mid-range? Well, not very good. The Modern Warzone AUG is just average all around, even when it's kitted optimally. Now, I don't have the numbers in front of me, but I'm almost positive this is one of the least used guns in the game, and I doubt that's going to change anytime soon. Most people, they forget it's even there. Next up, I hate to do this, Modern Warfare 2. The first AUG in COD history. It was a light machine gun called the AUG H-Bar, and if you're an old school player, you probably remember this gun. The AUG H-Bar dealt a flat 40 damage from any distance. It made it a 3-shot kill no matter what. Plus, if you threw on stopping power, it was a 2-shot kill no matter the distance. I mean, that's pretty insane. So, why is it all the way down here at the bottom? Well, because that power was balanced out with some pretty awkward handling traits that held it from being something truly special. It held it back. The AUG kicked quite a bit, and since it was an LMG, it had some hefty movement penalties. I mean, it also had a 42-round mag, which, that's kind of small for an LMG, although the quickly reload animation somewhat made up for it. So overall, the Modern Warfare 2 AUG was a very powerful gun. It just had some very powerful drawbacks. Some people loved it for its 2-shot kill potential, but its awkward handling puts it down here toward the bottom. Next up, Black Ops Cold War. Now in Warzone, this AUG is insane, but in multiplayer, it's just okay. I mean, it's more than okay, but not nearly as good as its Warzone counterpart. The Cold War AUG is a 3-round burst with pretty short burst delays. It gives it a noticeably faster fire rate than most burst weapons in COD. The AUG, it also boasts some extremely high damage. You can one-burst people from virtually any distance. Now, the high fire rate and the high damage are often offset by some awkward handling traits like bouncy recoil and higher idle sway, but if you know what you're doing in the gunsmith, you can pretty much eliminate all those problems. The Cold War AUG is very powerful, and it's really only held back by the fact that it's a burst weapon, and those will always be at a slight disadvantage in close range combat. Still, the Cold War AUG is very strong in the right hands. I think it's a fair place to put it. Now, understand, we're curving around here. We're not, just because it's not at the top, doesn't mean it's not a good gun. We just have to rank from the very worst all the way to the very best. Now, we have 3 AUGs left. Modern Warfare 2019. I've talked some crap a few minutes ago. Well, I actually talked crap. Yeah, it was in this video just a few minutes ago about this gun in Warzone. But in standard multiplayer, it's much better. Thanks to the much faster time to kill of Modern Warfare's multiplayer, the AUG SMG is much better and you can take much more advantage of its versatility by default. It still only has that little 25-round mag, but you can load it up with extended mags or even convert the ammo to 5.56 rounds to beef up the damage and the range. The AUG feels like an AR-SMG hybrid, and a weapon like that is much better in multiplayer than Warzone. It can kill with 3 bullets in multiplayer, despite its fire rate being pretty slow for an SMG. Its time to kill up close is one of the fastest in the class. I mean, it's got some high bullet damage. Now, overall, this AUG is a great choice for multiplayer Modern Warfare, and since it's the first SMG you get your hands on, you're going to have plenty of time to mess around with it. Now, the top 2. Well, there's only 2 left. Here we go. At number 2 today, Black Ops 1. One of the best AUGs in COD history. You can argue with me till you're blue in the face. It's not going to change my mind. It was the main rival to the infamous FAMAS. This was a full auto assault rifle, fired at 937 rounds per minute, the exact same as the FAMAS. This thing would hit for between 25 and 35 damage, made it a 3-4 shot kill. Guess what? The exact same as the FAMAS. What made this gun a little different from the FAMAS was the range drop-off and the recoil pattern. The AUG had the same 3-shot kill range as the FAMAS, but its damage dropped off a little differently beyond it. It also had a much different recoil pattern featuring more side-to-side recoil, which people tend to not really like. But this AUG was insane when it came to time to kill, and statistically, it has the exact same as the FAMAS in scenarios. Most people still use the FAMAS, of course, thanks to the more predictable recoil pattern, but some classy individuals stuck to the AUG to go against the grain a little bit. You put some Tiger Stripe camo on it, you're automatically going to win your match. So, what did you use in the original Black Ops? Was it the FAMAS, or was it the AUG? But there was one AUG that just barely beat out. I wanted so hard to put the Black Ops 1 AUG at number one, but I have to be fair to you guys. Cold War Zone. When we started writing this video, I thought I would be putting the Cold War Zone AUG at number two or three because I was positive it would be nerfed by now. But I was wrong. As of April 2021, and if you watch this video and it has been nerfed, forgive me. At this time, it hasn't been nerfed in Warzone. Its current state, I think it's the best we've ever had. Much like its multiplayer counterpart, the Cold War Zone AUG is a 3-round burst tactical rifle. Has a high rate of fire and some extremely impressive damage stats. In fact, it's a little too impressive. The Cold War Zone AUG has one of the fastest times to kill in the entire game, and it's been absolutely dominating the meta for months now. It blows my mind that this AUG hasn't been nerfed yet. Everybody was expecting the nerf to come in Season 2 Reloaded on the update, but guess what? It didn't happen. The Cold War Zone AUG is nuts. If you ask me, it's the best AUG in COD history. It's inevitable that this thing gets nerfed. It's going to. It has to. It probably already has since you've watched this video, and I'll have to update this list down the road when it happens. But as of right now, I have to put the Cold War Zone AUG at number one. And there you have it, my friends. That's every single AUG in COD history ranked from the worst to the best. You let me know where I got it right. Let me know your ranking. It's simple. You can do it in the comment section pretty quick. And let me know what you would like to see.